I'm going to do a banana coconut cake. So this is going to be something really nice. After making it, I will tell you what time we can use this. To make this cake, first I want 125 grams of sugar into a large bowl. Then we have 125 grams of butter. Before I start, I have to tell you, I have got 3 eggs ready. So what we are going to do is, slowly we are going to beat this sugar and butter first. Butter was just taken from the fridge and you can see it's so hard. So beat it slowly, slowly till the butter dissolves. If the butter doesn't get dissolved faster, one egg I will put first. In one direction you keep beating. I always tell that so that those who are watching the first time, they should know. Slowly reduce. Now I am going to use 150 grams of flour. Now we put the flour, 150 grams, and I will use the baking powder, 1 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder, salt a little, and sift it once. Now we mix the flour, baking powder and the salt together. Now we start beating this. We have already creamed it. While I am going to beat this, see, I am going to use 1/2 cup of coconut milk. Slowly I am adding coconut milk, not fresh milk. Then I am going to use a little dessert spoon of orange juice, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon powder. Keep beating it nicely. Now what we are going to do is, I am going to add bananas. I have taken about 4 bananas, right, and then put a little lime and mixed it and kept, otherwise it becomes discolored in no time. I have got a dessert spoon of desiccated coconut, that also I will use it. Cashew nuts also we use into this. That is about 30 grams of cashew nuts you use. And I need vanilla essence, 1/2 teaspoon. If you can get banana essence, well and good, you use the banana essence. 1 teaspoon here. Mix it well. Beat once. Let everything get blended together. That's enough. We don't have to beat for long. I have taken about an 8-inch tray. Then you put the butter on the sides as well and on the oil paper. I will put the mixture into the tray. Move more onto the sides. Leave a small gap in the middle so that when it's nicely baked, it will come to the level. My banana cake with coconut, we are going to bake it now. 180 centigrade, 360 Fahrenheit, you know, 45 minutes I have to bake. So we will bake and take it, and after that we'll see what I am going to do, what is the icing I am going to do for this. This is to be baked. After making this banana cake, we have to keep at least for 2 hours so that it gets cool, so that we can always do the decoration. Once the cake is baked, after 5 minutes, put it on the wire cooler and keep it. That's why you get all these checks. That is, wire cooler I put it on so that you will get, you know, cool it very fast. And if you keep with the tray itself, it will get hard because the tray heat itself is there, so it will become hard. So after 5 minutes, unmold and put it on the wire cooler, keep it. Now I am going to do the cream. Watch how we are going to make the cream. I am using 30 grams of butter and then I use honey, a dessert spoon of honey. Cream cheese I need, 3 teaspoons of cream cheese. All this together, now you cream it well. Sift the icing sugar, keep it ready. We put the icing sugar into this. I put about 3 dessert spoons. We'll see how much we need once it is added in it. It should be nice and creamy. 3 dessert spoons I put. Now another 1, 2. So almost 5 dessert spoons I have put. I would prefer to use a little vanilla essence. I'm going to put all this into that cake, on top of the cake. Using a palette knife, I slightly cashew nuts colored in pink, a little dark pink I have colored it. I have cut some bananas and kept want banana slices, little lemon juice. The color has changed, so what we have to do is we have to just brush it up with a little coloring so that it doesn't look discolored. Same cashew nuts colored in green. My banana coconut cake is ready. What, one more thing I have to tell about this cake. We put the cream. Once you put the cream, immediately don't decorate it. About 10 minutes keep it in the fridge. In the normal fridge you keep it for 10 minutes so that you know the cream gets set a little, and after that you can decorate it. After decorating, don't keep the cake in the fridge. Thank you for watching. I will come back to you with another episode very soon. Bye from me now.